Hi, let's learn how to create this beautiful rolling credits animation in PowerPoint. It's a beautiful animation that can be used in a number of ways. I'll not only show you how to create this animation, I will also show you how to have a continuous rolling credits where a certain set of elements keep repeating themselves over and over again. As you can see here, the same set of three text elements are rolling over and over again, and you can have this technique learned as well. And once you learn that technique, you can apply the same technique to a picture and you can have the infographic rolling over and over again. So your audience learn from whatever that you have taught earlier and they can revise the information over and over. So let us learn how to create this beautiful animation from scratch. But before that, I am Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program, a comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program for professionals. First of all, where do you use this kind of animation in your presentations? Let's say you've just finished a project presentation and you want to give credits to all the people who have contributed to the project, then you can use this rolling credits animation. Second, let's say you've just finished a product presentation and you want your audience to remember all the benefits of your products, then you can list down the benefits one below the other and you can have them rolling continuously while you answer the questions of the audience. Third, let's say you've finished teaching a set of principles, like in this case, we have taken 15 golden principles of visual hierarchy from a site called Design Mantic blog. And I can have these points revised over and over by having them rolling continuously. So there are a number of ways in which you can use this beautiful animation. And you'd be surprised to know that this animation is available as a ready-made animation right inside PowerPoint. Let me show you how to create this animation from scratch. Now, for the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to take just some random text. Now, to generate random text, I can pick up this text box tool from AutoShapes Gallery and let us use a simple formula called equals rand, which is the short form for random, open bracket, and let us say I want to have four paragraphs of five sentences each, and then close bracket and hit enter. Here you can see I have four paragraphs and each one has the same sentence repeated five times. Let me resize like so and I can have it somewhere narrower like this. And I can even increase the font size like so. And just to mimic credits, I'm going to give space between each of these lines by going to Home, Paragraph, and you can see this option here called Line Spacing. Let me use 2-point line spacing. Now, I need to apply a simple animation, which is available as part of the entrance animations. You click on this to open up more options and you say more entrance effects. And when you go down in the exciting option, you will have this called credits and you say OK. And by default, the duration is 15 seconds. It works perfectly. You don't really have to do anything. Now, when I go to slideshow, and when I click, you can see that the animation starts. If you want to have it start automatically, you can say with previous. And when you go to slideshow, automatically the animation starts. And you can see that all the text that we have written continues to show as rolling credits. It's as simple as that. Now let me show you how to make this loop continuously. Let me delete the space here. Make sure that all your text fits inside the slide area. So let us remove all the unnecessary text and you can see that the text fits right inside. This text has credits entrance animation already applied. Let us make a duplicate of this just so you know that I'm going to have this looped continuously. So let us press Ctrl D and this text is going to be in red font color so you can clearly differentiate. Let me place this right above the previous one. So now we have two animation events. Both of them have credit entrance animation with a duration of 16 seconds and they both happen with previous. The only change we are going to do is to go to the second animation event and add a delay of exactly half the duration. Since the duration is 16 seconds here, the delay needs to be 8 seconds and you hit enter. Now I want to have this repeat continuously, so let us select both the animation events while holding the shift button. Then click on the drop-down menu, go to Effect Options, go to Timing and say Repeat. until end of slide and you say okay. That's it. There is nothing else you need to do. When you go to slideshow, you can see that the first animation happens. You can notice that the text here is black in color. And just as the first animation gets over, the second animation automatically starts. And this continuous loop happens over and over again till you say escape. Now, it is pretty much the same idea when it comes to pictures. Let us say you've created an infographic to help your viewers revise all the points that you've just covered and ensure that this infographic or whatever picture that you choose fits nicely inside the slide area. Then you have this credits animation applied to it. Make a copy and then have the same credits animation applied to that as well. And you know the drill. For the second one, you have a delay of exactly half the duration. And once it is done, you align both of them one over the other. Now, before you go to the break, you go to slideshow and then leave it on, and you will see that all the principles that you have covered that are beautifully designed inside an infographic keep repeating over and over again. You can see that the first set of instructions are finished. Automatically, the same information is being looped over and over again. If you have not already signed up for our 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas free email course, then do yourself a favor and join this free email course right away. These are 25 useful, practical, and simple ideas that I don't share elsewhere. The link is in the description box below the video, or you can find the link right here on the right hand side. So click, join the course, and take your PowerPoint slides to the next level.